Oh boy, we finally have a British rank 5 premium! Finally! Oh, I'm so excited. What is it? FV Scorpion? Vickers MBT variant? Wait. Oh no.
Just a reminder before we start this video that we are hosting a giveaway on my Discord this week to celebrate my turning 21. So if you are interested in entering into the draw to win one of two $25 Steam gift cards, all you have to do to enter is be a subscriber, come join my Discord, link in the description, and follow the instructions in the giveaways channel there. The winner will be announced on Saturday the 26th, so get those entries in quick, lads. Good afternoon, you wee bastards, and welcome back to some more War Thunder with Koala. British tanks have long been a point of controversy in War Thunder. Some German players will complain that they're OP because of the comparatively low rank stabilizers and high penetration sable shells, while other players will say that they're very unreliable because of the sluggish handling and low post penetration effects of those aforementioned sable shells. Either way, however, you have to admit, we're getting screwed here. Seriously, Gaijin, that was underhanded to say the least. There was a world of possibilities for British premium rank 5 tanks and you decided to add an AVRE? This just doesn't make sense to me. Why not add further variations of the Vickers or light tanks like the FV Scorpion or VFM5? What about other combat based variants of the Centurion like the Australian Centurion Mk 6, essentially to the Cent 10 what the Carnarvon is to the Cent Mk 3? There are a whole host of other options too, but nope. Gaijin went with a bulldozer with a big fuck off derp cannon. This tank is based on the Centurion Mk 5, which was a Centurion Mk 3 with roof mounted machine guns, which you can see represented on this vehicle. It had ERA protection, a bulldozer bleed, and a 165mm howitzer designed for destroying buildings. It's more of a construction or destruction? Demolition, we'll go with that. It's more of a demolition or working vehicle, of course AVRE stands for Armoured Vehicle Royal Engineers, than say an AFV or an IFV, designed to do work on the back lines rather than enter the fray. It fires only plastic high explosive shells, or as we know them, HESH, so let's all see how effective or not they'll be in game come the 1.79 dev server. I should title this video, How to Sell Your Bulldozer. Jesus Gaijin, that was low hanging fruit. Of course, nobody would spend a full $50 on a hair-slugging Centurion derp gun when they could have the X-M1 Abrams prototype for the same price, so Gaijin thought they'd release this, nab all the shekels, and then less than an hour later, BOOM! X-M1! Hope you still want that AVRE you wasted all your money on. I suppose you could argue that Gaijin has saved some players the money by announcing the X-M1 so quickly afterwards, I will give them that, but oof, the poor people that bought this thing straight away not knowing the X-M1 was coming. Now, I'll admit, when I first saw this vehicle's dev blog, I was legitimately excited. It's an interesting looking vehicle, I like the look of the dozer blade and the ERA, and with explosive reactive armour on a Centurion chassis, and what will soon become the second biggest gun in the game behind the FV4005, it will be fun to play. But then of course, I had to go and look at the price tag. A full $50 for a derp cannon on a Centurion, probably at BR7.3+, yeah, no thank you. Not only is that the same price as the Magash 3, AMX-30 and Object 120, but it's more expensive than the German Kampfpanzer M47 and the same price as the XM1 prototype Abrams added just a few minutes later. Yeah, the poor sons of bitches who bought this tank are going to be screaming for the next few weeks, aren't they? Now, the pack comes with some 2 weeks of premium and a couple thousand golden eagles, as well as all the trimmings of a pre-order bundle vehicle, unique titles and decals, that sort of thing, and as Slickbee has said, it looks quite fun, for the first few matches you play in it. But to expect people to spend a full $50 on something that will not be all that competitive a vehicle, yeah, $20 and maybe I'd buy it. Maybe. Yes, we all know derp guns can be fun, weird looking vehicles can be fun. If this was something like a Churchill AVRE at tier 2 or 3, I'd be jumping on it in a second. But why can't we have an effective rank 5 premium, just like every other nation, bar Japan, and let's not even count Italy? Why ask so much for a vehicle that won't be effective for grinding? People would still buy this if you asked $20 of it. More people would probably buy it then. Now, don't get me wrong, I'd love this thing, and I'd have fun with it on streams and maybe in a video or two, but beyond being a source of hilarity, it's not something useful to players. I guarantee you 90% of the people that actually want this tank are either YouTubers or collectors. And to those people, I really hope you enjoy it, but I'm going to save my money for a proper British Rank 5 Premium. Let's see how long I have to hold my breath for, shall we? And lads, that is going to have to do it for this video. Please leave a like and subscribe if you enjoyed, as there will be new content out on my channel every single day. Leave your thoughts on the Centurion Mk5 AVRE in the comments section. Come join me over on Twitch, Twitter, Discord, and all the rest, links below. Remember to come join this giveaway before it ends in a couple of days, and as always, I will see you lads next video. See Funzo constructing the tank by optimizing the components of the aiming equipment and the gun stabilization system. Now that's why the Americans went with the Chrysler company, it was cheaper. These details played a decisive role in the selection of the contractor to make the X-M1 project a reality. In spite of the fact that numerous flaws and teething problems arose during the project, the prototype for the USA's next generation main battle tank was confirmed. After several cycles of correcting issues and modernizing the prototype X-M1C, the first vehicles began to be deployed under the designation M1 Abrams.